Welcome, everyone, to another episode of the Cover 2 podcast. I'm your co-host, Jared Smith.
And I'm your co-host, Nick Nenad.
And guys, we have an amazing show for you today. Football filled. Nick, we saw probably the best weekend of football I've ever seen in my entire life. I'm 31. I know you're in your 20s, and we've seen and watched a lot of football in our day. But this weekend was literally, we're going to say this a bunch of times on the show, the best weekend of games across the board. I know there was only four. That's all that we needed, right? We started off with the game, the Cincinnati Bengals and the Tennessee Titans on Saturday afternoon. And we ended Sunday evening with the Chiefs and the Bills in an all-time classic game. We're going to break down all those games. We're going to get into this upcoming weekend's championship round where we've got the two AFC teams, two NFC teams playing for the Super Bowl champion appearance. But we have to start with some breaking news that happened today, Nick. And there were some rumors swirling around this week, this past weekend, and early this week. And it was now confirmed today by himself. The man himself, Sean Payton, has officially stepped down from the head coach of the New Orleans Saints. So just give me your early thoughts on this, what you think, and if this was a surprise move to you or not.
Well, really quickly, let me start with this. Yeah, football was amazing this weekend. I'll tell you what I'm hot about today. It's the Baseball Hall of Fame vote. Barry Bonds, a couple others. Really quickly, though, I'm not going to talk about it in this podcast. We're going to go strictly football. Later on in this week, most likely Thursday, Friday, you're going to see me. I'm going to do a little rant on what happened because I don't like what's happening with the Baseball Hall of Fame. I don't like what's happening with baseball at all. So just a little preview, little teaser right there that's going to happen. But yeah, no, Sean Payton, shocking. Jared, when we were planning this podcast today, it was not a part of the podcast today to talk about Sean Payton. And now we're putting it in the beginning of the show. Yeah, it's shocking. Jared, if you follow me on Twitter, you already know my thoughts. I don't like this. I don't like this because I feel like Sean Payton is quitting on the New Orleans Saints organization because he doesn't have Drew Brees. He doesn't have that Hall of Fame quarterback anymore. And you know, he sees a couple struggling years. Maybe they make the playoffs a year or two. But realistically, they're not Super Bowl contenders anymore. And I don't like when coaches do that to an organization they've been loyal to for so long. I compare it to another great Hall of Fame coach in Bill Belichick. Bill Belichick lost the best player of all time and stuck it out and was able to make the playoffs this year, albeit getting murdered. But, I mean, if that guy can stick it out in New England, Sean Payton could have stuck it out in New Orleans. So, Jared, I don't like this very much. I'm hearing retirement. I'm hearing broadcasting career. I'm hearing the Dallas Cowboys in 2 years. I don't like it. I think he should have stayed with the Saints, give them a couple years, fix their cap issue, and try to rebuild the team. He's in his 50s. He's not in his 70s. You can't be retiring because your Hall of Fame quarterback retired on you.
Well, I can't really argue with what you're saying, right? And even though he did have a press conference today, I wasn't able to watch it. But what the reasons are, I don't think he came out in this press conference today and just kind of spilled his heart as to why he was actually walking away. Maybe to the actual team, to his players, to his coaches, he did behind closed doors. But, you know, there's a lot to unpack here, right? He still has 3 years left on his deal. And so it's not like he's a free agent coach or he was fired or let go or something like that. Like, he contractually still has an obligation to the New Orleans Saints franchise, and he is choosing to walk away. And as you mentioned, this team is somewhat in shambles. They don't have a franchise quarterback. Jameis Winston is coming off of a torn ACL. So who knows if and when he will be ready for next season and if the Saints even want to bring him back, right? And I believe they're going to be one of, if not the the most team or the team that has the least amount of cap space, right? They're going to be like $70 million over the cap.
Insane.
Which basically means in free agency, they're not going to be able to go out and add players. Like, they're going to have to, you know, trim the roster. They're going to have to restructure contracts and come up with interesting ways to get money back. just in order to survive, in a sense, right? Like, how are they going to even be able to pay for their upcoming draft? Like, the draft is not the end-all be-all, but when you are $70 million over the cap, right, this is not Major League Baseball. This is not the NBA where you are allowed to be over the cap and you just have to pay, like, a luxury tax, right? Like, that's why you see teams in Major League Baseball and the NBA, they're like, oh, whatever, we don't care. Like, we'll go over the luxury tax if we can get superstars. In the NFL, that is one way that they try to keep, you know, parity throughout the league, is that there is a hard salary cap. You cannot be over that. And if you are, there are dire consequences, as in a loss of draft picks, et cetera, et cetera. So you're right. It does seem like a very interesting time why he's moving away. And it's interesting you bring up Bill Belichick to think of another coach that left the college ranks and came to the NFL, and Pete Carroll, who left USC, maybe not Pete Carroll, or maybe, you know, maybe Sean Payton, this isn't as bad as Pete Carroll, because Pete Carroll left USC right as all those sanctions came down, and they basically got handcuffed, lost a bunch of scholarships, all that stuff. But this just also kind of seems a little eerie that you're leaving in a situation where the entire franchise is down in the dumps, and you're just walking away and leaving your guys hanging. So who knows what he's going to do? He obviously did not shut the door on not coming back. I think he just wants to take a year and recharge. And from a health standpoint, from a mental health standpoint, I can't argue with him if those are his real reasons. It's still just, it just doesn't seem the right move, like the right move, because you've got guys in that locker room. You have your coaching staff that is there because of you. Now, what are they supposed to do? When a coach gets fired, usually his entire coaching staff leaves with him. In this instance, he's choosing to step away. So now all the rest of his assistant coaches, you know, coordinators, all of that, they're like, ends up in the air, like, all right, what to do now? This is more than just Sean Payton stepping away from football.
Yeah, no, he's screwing over the team. That's what I'm trying to say. I mean, I get it. You've been there since 2006, and it's been 15 years. That's a long-ass time, Jared Smith, to be a head coach. There's not a lot of guys that are able to do that. You know, Mike Tomlin comes to mind. Bill Belichick, like I mentioned. But really, nobody else. I mean, fill in the blank if there's anybody else I'm stupidly forgetting. But, like, seriously.
John Harbaugh, I feel like he's getting up there a little bit.
That would be one that's not too bad. Yeah, not too far away. That's, you know, again, like, when the going got tough there, did he leave? No, he's like, let's get that Lamar Jackson guy and try to restart with this. It worked, right? I don't like it. I don't like that it seems like he's kind of copping out. And by the way, I respect retirement. I understand why he's leaving, and that's why I'm giving him shit. Because if you're a New Orleans Saints fan, you don't have to accept this. Like, again, Sean Payton became the head coach of the New Orleans Saints in 2006. And then they traded for Drew Brees. There was no years where Drew Brees and Sean Payton weren't directly connected with each other, until this year. And this year they struggled. They lost quarterbacks. They probably would have made the playoffs with Jameis Winston. But they don't. And now the roster's screwed. And he's quitting. I don't like it. Like I said, it'd be different if he was in his 70s. He's only in his 50s. He's younger than my father. So you can't be retiring and quitting on your team. But I guarantee, Jared, he's going to be back in the NFL in 2023. I guarantee it.
Oh, he will. And I will make a bet that it will be with the Dallas Cowboys.
That's what's so that's also so irritating about this, is the Cowboys are going to somehow be able to win a Super Bowl at the New Orleans Saints' expense. After all those years of the Saints trying to win Super Bowls with Drew Brees, all they're going to have to do is just hire Sean Payton, and they're just going to win the Super Bowl, right? Like, Bill,
But I don't want to get on the Dallas talk yet. I don't want to get my hopes up yet because I'm still reeling from the loss that they had. But you're right. It was brought up. It is a hot topic. He was a former coordinator with Dallas before he became the head coach with the Saints. So obviously he has some ties to Dallas and to Jerry Jones. And to me, that would be one of the only coaches that Dallas you know, should fire Mike McCarthy for. I think Mike McCarthy has been, you know, anything but perfect. He's made a lot of mistakes, but there are not too many other coaches that I would just all of a sudden, you know, fire him for, unless it was a Sean Payton, unless it was a Mike Tomlin or a Bill Belichick. You know, firing Mike McCarthy right now, not to get on this train, is more of an emotional move right now. You know, and I think you can say that with a lot of other coaches, right? I think you can even say that with Cliff Kingsbury, your Cardinals. I think right now the emotions are still high because we're still so close, you know, from the end of the regular season, that I think we need to let cooler heads prevail. And as we've seen so far, even with all the teams that have lost and did not make the playoffs, none of them have hired head coaches, right? They're still going through their coaching search. And so the longer that you don't make a decision and you kind of stay stuck in limbo, the less candidates that will be available. And so getting back to Sean Payton really quick, because I'll let you wrap this up. Here's my thing. At the beginning of this, I don't think we know the full extent as to why Sean Payton is leaving, unless, you know, I need to go back and watch his press conference and maybe he did actually come out and give the full truth. But to me, this has to be some type of health issue, whether it is physically, mentally, it has to be something like that. Because if you go back and listen to interviews from his current and former players, they all rave about Sean Payton. Like, there has never been an instance about Sean Payton's, you know, mindset or as far as being all in or all out. Like, it has to be something more than just him copping out because this team is in literal shambles and they don't have a quarterback and they don't have any money to go spend on free agents. Like, it has to be more than that. I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt until I hear otherwise. Like, yes, you make a great point. He is in his 50s. That doesn't mean that he can't have issues, right? Like, when you're a coach, you go through a lot. There's a lot of stress. There are a lot of other things involved. And so I want to hear him come out and say, like, no, I'm completely healthy. You know, it doesn't have to do with a health issue. Then I think your argument even becomes more valid. But right now, I'm going to give, you know, I'm going to keep that door open a little bit because right now I'm going to give, you know, I'm going to keep that door open a little bit because it coming from other